In this video, we want to talk about how to download and install DataSpell, which is one of the best available Python programming IDEs. And we are going to talk about how to work with DataSpell, the Jupyter notebook available in DataSpell, and other stuff. So please stay tuned. But before going further, remember that in the previous video, we have talked about how to download and install DataSpell and how to set up DataSpell. So if you don't know about these stuff, you can watch that video, which is, as a matter of fact, the previous part of this tutorial. So the link of that video is in the description below. And if you don't know about how to install and how to download and how to set up the DataSpell, you can watch that video. So now suppose that I want to create something like this. But before going further, let's change something in the DataSpell. I want to be able to change the font size using the control mouse wheel. So let's go to File, then Settings. Then here simply type mouse wheel. And you can see something like this, mouse control. And I want to be able to change font size with control mouse wheel in active editor. So I check this one and I press OK. So now you can see I can change the font using the control and mouse wheel. But now let's talk about how we can create something like this. And in this file, you can see that there were a couple of cells. This is one cell. This is another cell. This is another cell. And also this is another cell. And this is another cell. And this text cells are called markdown cells. This is also markdown cell. And also this is also markdown cells. But these cells, which contains code, is called code cell. So this is one code cell, and this is another code cell. So we have markdown cells, and also we have code cells. So first, we need to define a markdown cell in order to create something like this. And as you can see here, we have a cell. So this is a cell. And I want to convert this cell to a markdown cell, because now it's a code cell and it can start coding. For example, you can simply type import numpy as in p. So as you can see, it's a code cell, but I want to convert it to a markdown cell. In order to do so, first of all, press the escape key in order to exit this edit mode. So first of all, you should press the escape key on your keyboard. So that's it. But now you should press the M key, which stands for markdown. So remember to press the M key. So as you can see, it has been converted to markdown cell. And now we can simply type whatever you want. So I want to type data spell tutorial. And now I press control enter to modify the cell. But as you can see, the font size is not similar to this one. So in order to do that as well, I want to convert this one to header one, because this text is header one. So in order to do so, let's double click on this cell, which by double clicking on that cell, I will enter the edit mode. Now I put a hash before the text, and now I press the space key. And now if I press control enter in order to modify the cell, in order to apply the modifications in that cell, you can see now we have a header one. But remember that we have different headers. So for example, let's double click again in order to go to the edit mode, and let's type a couple of things. So we have different headers. So this is header one with one hash. And if you put two hash, it is going to be header two. And three hash means header three. Four hash means header four. Five hash means header five. Six hash means header six. But remember that we don't have such a thing called header seven. So if you put seven hash and you simply type header seven, you can see that we don't have such a thing called header seven. We have header one all the way up to header six. So if I press control enter, you can see this is header one, header two, header three, header four, all the way up to header six, but we don't have such a thing called header seven. So again, let's double click on the cell in order to go to the edit mode, and let's press control A on our keyboard in order to select all, and let's delete all the stuff. And now we want to simply use a header one in order to simply type data spell tutorial. So I can use that data spell tutorial. And I should press control enter in order to apply the modifications. And now I want to create another markdown cell below this cell. And you should notice that you shouldn't be in the edit mode. Remember that when you are in edit mode, so let's double click on this, you can see that it is very obvious that we are in the edit mode. You can see that this is the cursor and the color is green, and it's very obvious that we are in the edit mode. But if you press Control Enter, you can see now we are not in the edit mode. So it's very obvious that now we are not in the edit mode. When you have exit the edit mode, then if you press B, it stands for below, then you are going to create a cell below this cell, this current cell. So the current cell was this cell, and I have pressed B on my keyboard, so it has created a cell below this cell. And now once again, I want to convert this cell to a markdown cell. So I press escape key in order to exit the edit mode. And then I press M on my keyboard. It stands for markdown because I want to convert this cell to a markdown cell. So that's it. And now I can define this. I can define this kind of cell. So I want to type create a 2x2 matrix. So let's do that. And also remember that this is header 2. So let's define header 2. So I want to create a 2x2 matrix. There it is. And if I press Control Enter, you can see the modifications have been applied. So now let's create a cell below this cell. And as you can see, I'm out of the edit mode. So now I can simply press B on my keyboard in order to create a cell below this cell. B stands for below. So that's why you press B on your keyboard. So now if I click on it, you can see now I'm in the edit mode and I can type whatever I want. So I want to simply type these codes. So in order to create a 2x2 matrix, so I can simply type import numpy package as np. Then I want to define a 2x2 matrix. So I simply type np.array. And that's it. The first row is 1, 2. The second row is 3, 4. And I want to store that in a variable. Let's say called x. And now if I print the x variable and pay attention to this, it says, you know, you can see that it's a underscore. And if I press enter, you can see now it becomes 1. It means that this is the first cell which has been run. So if I run the code again, you can see it says 2. It says that it is the second cell which has been run. And if I press Control Enter, you can see it says 3. And every time I run this cell, the counter will increment by 1. Now let's create this one. And maybe you ask why I haven't created this markdown. Because after that, I want to teach you how you can insert a cell above that cell. So that's the reason I want to first create this cell. And after that, I'm going to create this cell as well. So let's do it. So suppose that I want to create this cell. So first of all, I should exit the edit mode. So I should press escape on my keyboard. And as you can see, it becomes blue. It means that now we are not in the edit mode. And now I simply press B on my keyboard. It stands for below because I want to insert a cell below this current cell. So that's it. And here I want to simply type these codes. So that's it. I can simply type np.random because I want to use the random section of this NumPy package. And I want to use the random function of this random section of this NumPy package. And I want to create a 3x3 matrix, which all of the elements are float random numbers between 0 and 1. This random function generates float random numbers between 0 and 1. And I want to generate a 3x3 matrix of that kind. So I store that in a variable, let's say called vi. And then I simply print the vi variable. And if I run a code, you can see it says 7, means it is the 7th cell which has been run, and you can see here's the output. But now suppose that I want to create a cell above this cell, and I want to type something like this. I want to create something like this. So in order to do so, first of all, I should exit the edit mode by pressing escape key on my keyboard. And now you can see that I'm not in the edit mode because this is blue. It means that I'm not in the edit mode. And now, in order to insert a cell above this cell, I should press A, stands for above. So if I press A, it stands for above, you can see now we have inserted a cell above this current cell. And I want to convert this cell to a markdown cell. So I should press M on my keyboard, and now we can see it's a markdown cell. So let's type these words. So I want to make it a header 2, And I want to simply type create a 3x3 matrix with random numbers. And then I press Control Enter to apply the modifications. Now you can see we have created all the stuff. And now let's run this code. But before that, pay attention to the numbers. It is 7 and this one is 6. So if I run the code, you can see it becomes 8. And remember that these numbers are according to run order. So I have run this cell after this cell, so it is 8. But now suppose that I want to restart all this stuff, or so-called, I want to restart the kernel, and I want to clear all the outputs. So in order to do so, I go to kernel, and I want to restart kernel and also clear outputs. So if I click on this, you can see it is restarting the kernel. And now we can see the outputs have been cleared as well. So now if I want, for example, to run this code, as you can see, I've restarted the kernel and I have cleared the outputs. So now if I want to run this cell, I'm going to encounter with error. Why? Because as you can see, no code cell has been run. So here I'm using a package called NumPy, but I haven't imported NumPy in this cell. I've imported NumPy in this cell, but I haven't run this cell. So if at first I run this cell, if I run this cell, which is the first cell which I have run, then you can see it gives me an error. It says name np is not defined. Why? Because np, I mean random, I mean NumPy, has been defined here, has been imported here. So this is the reason that we get error. So you should make sure that you pay attention to run order. This is the first cell which I'm running. And in this cell, I haven't imported NumPy, so I'm going to get an error. And now once again, let's restart the kernel and clear outputs. You can see it is restarting the kernel and the outputs have been cleared. So now let's talk about what is the difference between restarting the kernel itself and restarting kernel and clearing the outputs. Let's restart the kernel, not restart kernel and clear output. So let's restart kernel. Now we can see it is restarting the kernel. So the kernel has been restarted, but as you can see, the outputs have not been cleared. So now if I run this code, it is going to run that cell. And also it says this is the first cell which I'm running. And maybe you ask, so what's this? It is from the previous run, not this one. So this is the difference between restarting kernel and clear outputs and restarting the kernel itself. When you restart the kernel itself and you do not clear the outputs, you can see the outputs from previous runs, but the kernel has been restarted and it's like restarting all the stuff from scratch. So now this time I want to restart kernel and run all these cells. So I want to click on this. You can see it has restarted the kernel and it has run the code cells from the top to the bottom. But now let's talk about how we can insert a cell below this cell. So first of all, I should exit the edit mode by pressing escape key on my keyboard. That's it. And because I want to insert a cell below this cell, I press B on my keyboard. And as you can see, I have inserted a cell below this cell. So, and also I want to, let's say, convert this cell to a markdown cell. So first of all, I should exit the edit mode. So I should press escape key on my keyboard. And now you can see the border is blue. It means that I'm not in the edit mode. And now I can press M on my keyboard in order to convert the type of cell to markdown. And now suppose that I want to simply type, for example, this is a test cell. So I press Control Enter to apply the modifications. And I want to insert another cell below this cell. So I press B on my keyboard. That's it. And here I want to simply print 5 times 8. And if I press Control Enter, you can see here is the result. But now suppose that I want to delete these two cells. In order to do so, remember that first of all, you should exit the edit mode. That's it. And now after exiting the edit mode, you should select the cell that you want to delete. Suppose that I want to delete this cell, so I should select that cell. Remember that When you are selecting a cell, it becomes blue. So for example, if I'm selecting this cell, it is blue. And remember, but when it becomes green, it means you are in the edit mode. So remember to, first of all, exit the edit mode. And when you exit the edit mode, it becomes blue. And because this cell is blue, it means that we have selected this cell. So for example, suppose that I want to delete this cell. So first of all, I should select this cell. And I should press D twice, 1, 2. I have deleted this cell. And if I want to press, and if I want to delete this cell, I should press D twice. So you can see I have pressed D twice and I have deleted that cell. Now let's talk about these buttons. In order to navigate between these cells, in order to move between cells, you can use these arrows in order to move between cells. So for example, now you can see that this cell has been selected. But if I press move cell down, you can see I can move down. And if I press this, you can see I can move up. And if I want to insert a cell below another cell, so for example, I select this cell. And if I press this plus sign button, you can see it is going to insert a cell below this cell. But now suppose that I want to copy this cell and insert that cell below this cell, below the cell that I have selected. In order to do so, first of all, I should select this cell and I should copy that cell using this icon. Then I should scroll down and I should select this, and then I should simply press the paste button. So you can see that it has been inserted below this cell. So you can see now we are in the edit mode, and if I press Control Enter, you can see now the modifications have been applied and the cell have been pasted here. So once again, let's select this cell, and I want to cut this cell, and I want to paste that below this cell. So I use the paste button. So you can see it has been pasted here, and if I press Control Enter, you can see the modifications have been applied. And now suppose that I want to delete this cell. In order to do so, I select the cell and I click on this, and you can see the cell has been deleted. Now suppose that I want to change the type of this cell to Markdown. As you can see, when I select this cell, it says by default, it's a code cell, but I can change the type of this cell. So I can click on this and I can convert it to a Markdown cell. So you can see it's a Markdown cell. So let's type something. So let's, for example, simply type hi, and if I press Control Enter, that's it. And now let's insert a cell below this cell. So here you can see, and for example, let's print something, print 5 times 5. And also let's insert another cell below this cell. So here I want to print, let's say 5 times 8, that's it. And for example, suppose that I want to run this cell. So in order to do so, I can click on this icon, which says run this cell, and select the cell below that cell. So if I run this cell, you can see this cell has been executed and the cell below has been selected. And now if you press this button again, you can see that this cell has been executed. But because there wasn't any cell below this cell, it has created a cell below that cell. So it has inserted a cell below that cell because there wasn't any cell below it. And now let's delete these cells. So I want to delete this, I want to delete this, and this, and also this. But now suppose that I want to restart the kernel. In order to restart the kernel, I can click on this, restart kernel. And you can see it is restarting the kernel. And if I want to clear all the outputs, I can click on this icon, which you can see all the outputs have been deleted. And if you want to run all the codes available in this Jupyter IPython notebook, you can simply press this icon and it's going to run all the codes available. And that's it. And as you know, we have talked about all of these icons except this one, which is the debug, which maybe in some other videos, in future videos, we are going to cover that as well. But remember that we have a video about how to debug PyCharm, which is very similar to DataSpell, which you can see that as well, in order to get a better insight of what is debug. Now I really suggest you to watch this video, which is on the screen now.